Okay, round number two. This looks like a pretty likely to cycle sandworm type hand. I think many times if it's in your opener, you want to cycle it. Now I'm like guaranteed to cycle it. Cartouche, sure. That's the baddest fan bear I've ever seen. I'm just going to stick with this here. Sorry, greatest sandworm. But you're going to the bin. Actually, you know what the hell I'm going to do against this fan bear with Cartouche of Knowledge on it? It's kind of an issue. It's going to do a lot of damage. I guess I could wrap it up. It's a lot of wrappings, though. It's already a mummy. Slightly embarrassing, but taking two a turn for the foreseeable future here does not seem good. I mean, I'm going to take 12, 14 damage off that thing by the time the game's over, which would be far too soon, in my opinion. Now I can go Quarry Hall or Cartouche, or something like that, but... Taking one doesn't really bother me. Think I'm flying? Ugh. This is going to be a precarious... Ooh. Ding. I will play this card. Wow, that was sweet. This card's so sick. Look at this. Now we're just taking one a turn. I also just like getting this thing going as soon as possible because, you know, you want to get the bricks up on it. My opponent probably has that removal spell, I suppose. Gonna pass. If they're not gonna pressure me, I don't need to run Quarry Hauler into counter spells or into removal and then not be able to use my edifice for the turn. I wish this was on tap because I would just run it out, but I don't wanna take three in the air because of it. And also just because it's like I don't want to let them use their mana in like super efficient way either. Like if they've got the thing. Oh no. Yep. Fan bearer is once again in there. Okay. Sweet combo. I guess I don't have enough mana still. I would have liked to put the cartouche down, but I don't want to take the risk. 2-1-1 white soldiers. Okay. Or warriors. Yeah, okay. This is getting a little sketchy for us for sure. So tap this. Get this thing. Finish. Right. Sack one of the dudes. All right. Ah, I see. Okay, well, it didn't punish us, but I should remember that this is until my next turn, so I can use it on the fan bearer so that they can't tap something down. Like, for example, if I draw a land here, I may want to do that. That lets me trade. Is that my actual goal here? Probably. Bad spot, bad spot. So, more lands is fine. Like, I can lay claim one of these things and then still have this going. Here, I can just trade for this, I suppose. Ah. I take 3, 6, 7. All right, well, I'm not dead. I mean, I'm kind of dead, but I'm not dead. Oh, they're not. Actually, I'm taking 6. Still, I am significantly behind here. But wait, there's more. Another Gustwalker, sure. So if I tap that thing down, I go block, block, and I die. But if I let them tap anything down, then I die anyway. So I'm just going to die. Still make them do it. This is pretty bad for us. Without it, I think we maybe stabilize, but because we probably just would have played lay claim. All right, so what can we do here? Stinging shot, yes. Still think this is too bad, though. This trades off, so that's good. These trade off. Seems fine. Like bringing these type of cards in against these decks. I'm not going to do it. All right. Could go to our other build. I want to see a little more about what our opponent's up to, though. We saw some flyers, but it was kind of hard to figure out exactly how flyer dense they really are. All right, this looks good. This looks really good. The Shimmer Scale Drake's excellent against my opponent's strategy as well. Wow, okay. I like the Vizier of Tumbling Sands here as well. I'm not planning on cycling it, so I'm going to play the forest so I can Stinging Shot in case there's a flyer I haven't thought of. That is one, but not the one I really wanted. All right, this is business. I'm just going to run this guy out. This is our little ramp spell here. This gives us Shimmering Drake next turn. Cartouche. All right, well, that actually works out pretty well for us, too. I can Stinging Shot that if I want. I could just still run out the Shimmer Scale Drake. I'm going to take the middle ground. And play this Quarry Hauler. And then my plan is to still Stinging Shot here. Curious what my opponent does, though. I'm going to let them attack. Attempts to kill. Perfect. That is absolutely perfect. The question is, do I want to attack with the hauler? And I think the answer is yes. They may trade it off because it has embalm anyway, but I think they're not. Yeah. All right, I guess I have to do the mana first. All right. Lovely, lovely. Block there. Or hopefully just dissuade an attack. Very nice. Gustwalker. Really don't want to trade off here now because I think they'll just trade and just try to grind. I could just attack with this, but I'm not in love with that play either, just because it opens up such a nasty backswing that forces me to trade off my own Aven Initiate, which is like medium for me, I think. One play I could make, it's pretty aggro, is I could Wrappings this. They're not going to be able to embalm it for a while. And then I could just jam with both creatures. Another play that makes sense. I think that's the one I'm going to make. Is I'm going to attack with Shimmer Scale. And Quarry Hauler. Yeah, I'm getting in. This is such a clunky card. It's a good card, but it's like, this is a value trade for them, but we have that same value on our side. And I like just getting stuff off the board for them. So I'm going to do that. And then what I'm going to do is, oh, they got minus, they got counters for us too, it looks like. Oh, Jiro's Resolve. Okay. That's fine too. And then I'm going to play this thing and this thing. And then I've still got the Vizier to block, to untap my Shimmering Drake to prevent any attacks from my opponent. And when I untap, I'm going to have infinite mana. So it all kind of works out. What is this? Really? Well, I'm falling for it. They've got the exile a creature, I guess. No? All right, well, I'll fall for the combat trick too then. I see. I like it. I like what I'm seeing here. They forgot. That's what that was. Sure, five. Oh. Stupid. Could have untapped it. It just blanks that. I thought, well, I'll just replay it, but it sets them back a whole card. Ugh, that was stupid. Usually you want to fizzle your opponent's spells when it's on board. What is this one? Gets lifelink, becomes a 4/4 lifelink exert. It's reasonable. You take five. All right. Not this time. We still get the card? I did once. All right. So you take all that. So my original plan was to untap this so that I could cast Aven Initiate and leave up mana for this so I could block this thing and just sack so they can't gain any life. Now I'm considering just putting wrappings on this. I really do want to get this Aven Initiate down, though. I think I'm just going to do that. Oh, I see. That's kind of cool. So my opponent's plan was to play Gale Strike, then I was going to untap, and then if I untap my guy, they were just going to play another one. Which I don't think is great, but at least, they at least had a plan for it. But I botched it. Alright, well, this turned out good. This doesn't actually work out for them, I don't think. They draw 2, gain 4, I take 7, they go to 10. I've got 3, 6, 7, 8, 9. Oh, I guess it does. Totally works. It's pretty good. So if I steal this guy, I still get an in for 3, 5, 8, 9, putting in the 1. How much mana can I make? I can make 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, which is exactly how many I need to do both things, which I think I should do. Okay, well, I'm definitely rumbling. Here and here. Oh, I don't have enough blue, do I? So I think I'm just stealing something then. Which I take. This is exerted. It's unlikely to be able to untap. I have a blocker for this thing anyway. If this thing does get untapped, can I lose? It's hard. 4, 5, 6, even if they have another one of those open into wonder. So I'm just going to take this thing. Suppose I could just untap it myself and attack. That'd probably be pretty good too, but the fact that it just stays tapped for them is such a liability that they have to like come up with a card that untaps it, and even then it's not great for them. So, still kind of an annoying, evasive deck. Man, these things would be good again. They really would. It's okay, I need to think about this sideboarding anyway. Might not be better. Might not be better. Really do like these Seraph of the Suns, though, against these decks. They're just, if you can stick one, it's just so tough for them to get through it with their flyers. But they're just so slow as cards. where like sometimes you just play quarry haulers and just start smashing them with them, you know, ahead of time. Yeah, let's try it. All right. Well, I wanted to land a Seraph of the Suns, and this probably gives me the best shot of it. Boy, is it slow, though. We'll see how it goes. I think I'll be glad I have that. Card I really want to counter is Fanbearer, but Ghostwalker is pretty good too. Okay, I'm going to pass here, and we have a big decision on if I want to cycle lay claim or not, and I think I do. We do not have the mana to cast it yet. Next turn, I'm going to be activating the Cultivator most likely. So I think Lay Claim is probably a little too far off in the distance for us here. This probably isn't, though. Because this turn we're going to cycle the Cultivator. That puts us at 4 and then 5 mana, so we're one away from both of these. Wow, okay. It's probably not too bad that that thing's in there. Hopefully they don't have the Aven here. Boo. They have the Aven here. Okay, so I can do that anytime I want. And I can still leave up Essence Scatter. That seems good. I don't like this, though. Taking a beating here. Probably just 5, but still, it's a lot. Could be in really bad shape. We're wanting them to just tap out, I think. For a creature. Perfect. This has Embalm 6. Whew. All right, let's just start slamming Seraphs of the Suns. Zzz. And see if that gets the job done. This was our plan. This one, maybe it dies. This one, hopefully it lives. No, the Fanbearer's here. Oh, you're exactly who I didn't want to see. Oh. Take him? Gimme? Yes. That is very good. Next turn, we'll probably, let's see here, 4/8, we'll probably play Wing Shepherd and leave up Fanbear. Okay, man, I just don't want to lose to the unblockable spell. I think we actually may need to draw or gain 7 at some point here. How crazy is that? Like, they may just fire it off here and draw a bunch of cards. Especially because we have this now. If they have it in their hand, they have kind of a tough decision, because on one hand, you could wait until you have lethal and then go for it. But on the other hand, the shields are down and this is a time to draw 3 cards. Yeah, funny, because, you know, this makes it harder for them to get to that point. Probably going to lose now. Drawing 3 cards and putting us to 5 is pretty big game, even with what we have. Now, if we draw the life gain spell, then I actually would think we actually have a shot, because we'll be at pretty high life total. Oh. I have 9 mana? 4, 7, 9. I have 9 mana. All right. I accept. So what happens if I attack here? Not good things. It's nice against Fanbear that I stole. The hell's going on here? Cartouche also, okay. Cast out. That's very good. I may need to just cast out the Vizier here. If I cast out the Vizier, then the Fanbearer still actually does something. If I don't, then whatever I Fanbearer down just gets untapped anyway. So let's say I Fanbearer this or this, they untap it, and then they can attack with all of them. I go block, block, take a bunch. Guy actually gets to 5 toughness when it attacks. That's pretty annoying. Yep. This king has flying now too. Well, it's about as close as they get. Ah, game over. GG's. Suppose I should cycle that. All right. Those were good games. I knew the game was over when they cast the unblockable spell, though. It's just so hard to recover from that. Unless I drew a couple of specific cards, which I didn't. But it's so hard to recover from that when you're trying to stabilize. All right, well, we got one more round.